Welcome to all. Hope you are fine and safe. Here, now we are entering to the new academic year, and I expect for some extent we have to continue this online class, isn't it? In the last year, we have gone through 6 units, and each unit emphasized with a good theme, and it was successful to our life. And now, this year, that is for plus two, we have 5 units. And our first unit is Flights of Freedom. Here, the Flights of Freedom, what it means? Are you getting freedom? Yes, partially. Are you utilizing the freedom in a good manner? Yes, partially. Isn't it? So here, freedom is very important, not only for men but for women also. Here, in this lesson, here is a speech by Christine Lagarde. It's a speech by Christine Lagarde. It was saying how women are giving more importance, how she was giving more importance to women and their potential. Here, no country can flourish without the support of women, isn't it? Or without utilizing the potential of women. Without women, man's life will be like a desert land. They are the asset of our society. Some social reformers, athletes, and some social leaders, example Indira Gandhi, Mary Kom, P.T. Usha, Kiran Bedi, these are the few ladies who placed our nation to the prestigious level, isn't it? So the two things, that is emancipation and empowerment, these two things are the prime importance of for our society. The emancipation and empowerment of women are the prime importance of our society. Here it's a speech. Here, the three L's of empowerment is a speech by Christine Lagarde. Here, let us go through about Christine Lagarde. Christine Lagarde, born in Paris on 1st January 1956, is the first woman to become the finance minister of G8 economy and to head the International Monetary Fund, IMF. Here, Christine Lagarde is the first woman to become the finance minister of G8 economy. What is the meaning of G8? What is the meaning of G8? It's a group of 8 nations, highly industrialized nation. Here, which are the nations? The France, Italy, Germany, then United States, UK, Japan, Russia. They are making the nation for the upliftment, and they are discussing about the crisis management and how to overcome that. And the next one, to head the International Monetary Fund, IMF. She calls for opening the doors to women's learning, labor and leadership. In the economic field, the speech was delivered at the National Democratic Institute. So, this is a speech. And it was delivered at National Democratic Institute, Washington, on 19th May 2014. Okay, now let us enter to the lesson 3 L's of empowerment. I told you that emancipation and empowerment of women are the prime importance of society. What is the meaning of emancipation? What is the meaning of empowerment? Here, emancipation means getting freedom. Empowerment means, what is the meaning of empowerment? Meaning getting power. So these two things, which are very important for women, for their progress. Here, in our country, we have achieved partially success. Here, we have achieved the freedom and power. At partial, isn't it? So here, but we still have a long way to go, but still we have to achieve. We have to achieve the goal. What should we do to achieve this goal? What are the things we have to do to achieve this goal? That was the speech given by Christine Lagarde. Okay. Here, the 3 L's of empowerment. The 3 L's of empowerment. Good afternoon. It is great to be among friends and kindred spirits. It's a speech, isn't it? So, it is starting in a formal way, isn't it? Good afternoon. It is great to be among friends and kindred spirits. Here, what are the kindred spirits? The people who are thinking in the same way. The people who are thinking alike. So that is called as kindred spirits. Okay. Here, the 21st century poses many challenges that require new ways of thinking. Okay, the 21st century poses many challenges, and that helps to require the new ways of thinking. So the 21st century, at that time, the women are facing number of challenges. In those times, the people, that is especially women, the girl children, they are getting education and they are sitting in the four walls of their house. They are not coming forward. They are not ready to what? Getting for the job. Why? Then they don't dare. They don't have dare to face the challenge. Why it's like that? Still, the women are not roaming in the night time. It is due to lack of freedom. Don't you think like that? Okay, here the challenges, the people, that is the girls, they are studying, they are getting education, and they are sitting in their house. They don't want to face the challenges. The parents, they are not sending their children to tour or for studies in abroad, isn't it? So these are all due to lack of freedom. Freedom is necessary, but the women, they are getting only partially. Here, the 21st century poses many challenges that require new ways of thinking. So, the challenges make to rethink or make the new ways for thinking. None more important than the economic role of women in a rapidly changing world. None more important than the economic role of women in a rapidly changing world. The world is changing rapidly, quickly. Isn't it? Rapidly here meaning quick. And so for the economic importance, women is also very important. Women potential is very important, isn't it? So here, none more important than the economic role of women in a rapidly changing world. But women today remain blocked from contributing their true potential. They are not able to. Women are not able to contribute their abilities, their potential. Why? They remain blocked. They remain blocked. Why they remain blocked? What may be the reason? Here, this has a huge cost, isn't it? This has a huge cost. In some countries, per capita income lag insignificantly because women are denied equal opportunities. In some countries, the per capita income lag The annual income is lagging. Why? Why it was lagging? Because women are denied equal opportunity. Women are not getting equal opportunities. Okay, denied kya mene? Not getting the equal opportunities. Only men are getting the opportunities, women are not getting opportunities. That's why the per capita income was lagging. Okay, that's why the per capita income was lagging. Here, they represent half the world's population, but contributing far less than 50% of economic activity. Here, the women are representing half the world population. In the world population, half are women, but they are not contributing anything. They are contributing only less than 50%. And so, what's happening? The 50% of economic activity, they represent half the world's population. They are representing half the world population. So in the world, 50% are women, but they are not representing, they are not contributing that. They are contributing less than 50%. Again, here, what is needed to change this picture is a concerted effort to open the door to opportunity with what I call the 3 L's of women empowerment: learning, labor, and leadership. What is needed to change this picture? How can we change this picture? Here, Christine Lagarde is saying that by having 3 things, you can overcome this. You can overcome this. You can change the picture. Which are the 3 things she was explaining? First one, learning. Second one, labor. And third one is leadership. Okay. So here, which are the 3 things? First one, learning. Second one, labor. Third one is leadership. By having these three L's, here the heading is 3 L's of empowerment, isn't it? Here the 3 L's of empowerment, that the 3 L's, what are the 3 L's? First one, labor, isn't it? Okay, first one, learning, labor, and leadership. Okay, here, let me start with the learning. Here, the 3 L's of women empowerment is learning, labor, and leadership. Okay. Here, now we are going to see the 3 things, that is learning, labor, and leadership. These things we can see in the next class. Okay, thank you.